Welcome to GPL Capital Talks on Tuesday, a weekly podcast, bringing to you an interesting talk related to finance every week. Stay tuned. Hello everyone. GPL Capital brings to you Talks on Tuesday, a weekly podcast, episode number 38. Our today's topic is 3 Trading Mistakes You Should Avoid by Mr. Karan Pai, Technical Research Analyst. Over to you.
While some trading mistakes are unavoidable, it is important that you do not make a habit of them and learn from both successful and unsuccessful positions. With that in mind, these are the 3 most common trading mistakes. First, trading without a plan. Second, failing to cut losses. Third, not understanding the risk reward. First, trading without a plan. Trading plans should be the blueprint during your time on the markets. They should contain a strategy, time, commitment, and the amount of capital that you're willing to invest. After a bad day on the market, traders could be tempted to scrap their plan. This is a mistake because a trading plan should be the foundation of any new position. A bad trading doesn't mean that the plan is flawed. It simply means that the markets weren't moving in the anticipated direction during a particular time period. One way to keep a record of what worked and what didn't work for you is to have a trading diary. This would contain your successful and unsuccessful trades and the reasons why they were so. This can help you learn from your mistakes and make more informed decisions in the future. Second is failing to cut losses. The temptation to let losses running is in the hope that the market turns can be a grave error, and failing to cut losses can wipe out any profit a trader may have made elsewhere. This is particularly true on day trading or short-term trading strategies because these techniques rely on quick market movements to realize a profit. There's little point in trying to ride out temporary slumps in the market, as all active positions should be closed by the end of the trading day. While some losses are an inevitable part of the trading, stops can close the positions that is moving against the market at a predetermined level. This can minimize your risk by cutting your losses for you. You can also attach a limit to your position to close your trade automatically if it has secured a certain amount of profit. The third mistake is not understanding the risk-reward ratio. The risk-reward ratio is something every trader should take into consideration as it helps them decide whether the end profit is worth the possible risk of losing capital. For instance, if the initial position was Rs. 2000 and the potential profit was Rs. 4000, the risk-reward ratio is 1:2. Typically, experienced traders tend to be more open to risk and have suitable trading strategies in place. Beginners traders may not have much appetite for risk and could well want to steer clear of markets that can be highly volatile. Regardless of how open you are to risk, you should have a risk management strategy in place during your time in the markets. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you, Mr. Karan Pai, for this interesting insight. Stay tuned for our next Tuesday Talks, where we will be talking to you about where will equity market be in 2023. Also use the hashtag AskExpert@GEPL Capital on Twitter and get all your questions answered on the stock market.